Hancock welcoming you to the Brampton Center for Sports and Entertainment and OHL Primetime here on Rogers Sports. This afternoon marks the first of six meetings between these Midwest Division rivals, the Brampton Battalion and the Owen Sound Attack. Coming into this afternoon's game, the Owen Sound Attack trail the Brampton Battalion by just 2 points for the eighth and final playoff spot in the West Conference. As for the Brampton Battalion, they've been very busy this week on the trade front as they've shipped out Travis Parent and Jonah LaRue, and in return, they've acquired Sebastian Savage and Grant Buckley. Now, for more on today's game, as the Brampton Battalion put their seven-game undefeated streak on the line, we'll go upstairs to Doug Anderson and Sam Cosentino. Gentlemen.
Tonight's starting goaltender for the Owen Sound Attack, sitting in the net wearing number one for Owen Sound, is Corey Roberts.
Well, Dougie, he's been the backup for most of this year. He's a four-year OHL veteran. Comes into this afternoon's hockey game with a 1-4-2 record and .884 save percentage, 4.28 goals against average. Justin Day, who we'll talk about a little bit later on in this hockey game, has been the main guy for Owen Sound. He gets to sit tonight after having played the last six games. Corey Roberts between the pipes.
Joey Biasucci between the pipes for the Brampton Battalion. We saw Biasucci last time on OHL Primetime, absolutely outstanding against the Kitchener Rangers.
Well, Joey Biasucci has had two starts against the Kitchener Rangers. Both, I believe, are wins this season. He is the back end of a duo of goaltenders that are 17 years old, the only duo in the OHL with two 17-year-old goalies. Biasucci comes into the game with a record of 3-2-1, an outstanding save percentage of .910, and he's allowed just 3.23 goals a game. Biasucci, the son of Sam, part owner of the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds.
McClement, Van Lusen, Rowan up front for the Battalion, up front for the Attack. And Siska wears number 9. Greg Jacina, number 7. Kyle McAllister, number 19. Bounce through the neutral zone. Retreating to pick it up is Jay Harrison.
Battalion with a few chances to start this hockey game, but Corey Roberts able to handle all the shots so far. He's played in seven games, allowed 30 goals, a 4.28 goals against average. He's a guy that Justin Day will learn from.
Henrik scores from the circle, picks up the loose puck, and puts it past Corey Roberts as the Battalion jump out to a 1-0 lead.
Well, the magic continues for Adam Henrik. He scored the game-winning goal in the last two Battalion wins, a two-game win streak. Here he opens the scoring. Again, one of those plays that comes from the side of the net out in front. Adam Henrik with his ninth of the year in the Battalion lead at 1-0.
So the Battalion have shut down Owen Sound thus far. Owen Sound yet to get their first goal, first shot on net.
Well, we see the replay. Watch Henrik. He goes from the corner. Now he brings it out in front of the net, gets himself a little better angle, finds a spot. He goes 5-hole on Corey Roberts for his ninth of the year.
Turco into it. Buckley leads the Attack. Gets it over to Rowan. Rowan through the middle. He's got Van Lusen heading to the front of the net. Great opportunity. And Roberts stones Van Lusen. He'll dump it through the neutral zone. A giveaway passes Owen Sound as Courtney on the near side. Bounced outside the blue line with Sullivan by Robinson, and jumping up in the play is Luby. He tries to make his way around Courtney, and we got Robinson as he attacks his man from behind. That's Dan Sullivan going to the ice. Sullivan kept his gloves on, lost his bucket. Chad Robinson upset.
Yeah, he really got under the skin. Sullivan really got under the skin of Robinson, and Robinson just took it upon himself to start a fight. Very similar to what we saw in the first of two New Jersey-Toronto hockey games where Jim McKenzie challenged Ty Domi. Domi just kind of turtled, and what happened there? A 7-minute penalty resulted for the Leafs. I think we're going to see something very similar here as Sullivan decided not to take Robinson up on the fight. You see Robinson is already headed to the box. He'll sit down. We'll get the penalties for you in just a moment.
Lines up Turcotte. Buckley pinches in. Gives it away. Siska, he's got a man with him. Siska, turnaround pass to Jacina. He scores! What a nice give and go!
Oh, man, what a play by Siska. It did the old Savardian spinorama. Instead of shooting it on the net, made the pass across the ice. And a fantastic goal for the Owen Sound Attack as they tie this hockey game at one. Love to see this replay. Grant Buckley caught pinching at the blue line, the recently acquired Grant Buckley, and that allowed Owen Sound to go out on a 2-on-1.
The whole play started at the Owen Sound blue line. Sisko, what a nice pass as Harrison's going down.
Yeah, Harrison tried to avoid the pass, and by Sisko going to the back end, he was able to avoid the stick of Harrison and get the puck across the ice. We get a better look from a hockey. Harrison's out of the play, and the trailing, I believe that's Adam Henrik, the trailing
Sebastian Savage, and he just stopped skating, coming back into his own zone.
Yeah, anytime that the defenseman pinch, you have to watch and make sure if you're a forward that you cover up the point. Shots on goal, 15-13 in favor of Brampton. So the Owen Sound goalies have seen quite a workload.
Sisko just picks up a beautiful goal as he picked it off the draw, turned to the center of the ice and fired a wrist shot past Biasucci.
Well, the faceoff came into the Brampton zone as a result of Hatsiano touching up on the icing. Owen Sound has had a little trouble doing that. Well, this time they get it done, get the faceoff just to the left of Biasucci, and what a shot by Sisko. He went upper tank right off the crossbar. It went into the net from there, and this is one of those goals that had it been in the NHL, they probably would have went upstairs to look at it, but nonetheless, clearly from our vantage point, it was a goal. Sisko's 10th of the year, and now he has a goal to go along with assist. But you see Jacina win the draw, and then Sisko just fires it, beating Biasucci. He had a good look at it, but you have to give all the credit in the world to Jacina, who won the faceoff mean and clean back. I know Stan Butler preaches that. He will not be happy with those two mistakes that nearly cost another goal here.
Dalladay's shot from the point goes off a boot. Wheaton backhand, loose puck in the crease, they score! Chapman's going to get the goal. Owen Sound goes up by a pair.
Well, he and Corey LeClaire went to the ice at the same time, but Chapman was able to sneak it along the ice past the diving Joey Biasucci. And just like that, in what started to be a very boring second period, Owen Sound has come out to score two quick goals. They now, the attack now lead it 2-1. But again, a loose puck comes out in front of the net, and there's no one there. You see Corey LeClaire, he gets there a little bit late on the play. Four Brampton Battalion players standing in the area, and you get a better look at it right here. Savage again, puck goes right past him, and now you see four Brampton players all within the same area, but it's Chapman who's able to get the goal and put the Owen Sound attack up 3-1.
Three periods, and it's going to catch up to them sooner or later.
Yeah, no question. As a coaching staff, that's a kind of a disturbing trend.
McSween robbed by Roberts with a big glove hand save.
Well, we just finished talking about it. Henrik with a great pass, cross ice to McSween, who was in the middle of the ice.
To pick it up is Rogers. Rogers gets it to the blue line. LeClaire keeps it in. To the side of the net. Loose puck. Backhand shot from Henrik. Clayton gets an opportunity. Puck is still loose. McSween to Schwantz. He drifts one to the front of the net. What a huge save from Corey Roberts. Back to the point for Power. Back to Jacina. Clement gets a piece of him. Biasucci, loose puck. Harrison shot. That goes off the boot. A Ryan bonus.
They pass Roberts.
This time, it's McAllister winning the draw. Comes back to Flack. He has it, plays it in the corner, and the zone is cleared again. Jacina through center. Harrison ties him up. Jacina plays it in the corner, and McSween gathers it up. Time for one more run. Long pass goes awry through the middle, and Colt is just going to tip it away, and that'll do it for this hockey game. So the Owen Sound attack will come away with a big 3-1 victory over the Brampton Battalion on the road.
Well, Brampton heeded the advice, got a lot more shots on goal in that third period. We're still outshot in this game, 29-27. But the lack of traffic in front of the net allowed the veteran netminder Corey Roberts to keep this game in hand as Owen Sound picks up a road victory.
And a big victory it is for the attack. 3-1 the final score from the Brampton Center. We're going to come back with more of OHL Primetime. Stay with us. We're going to come back with the Hammer, Mike Hancock.
Welcome back to the Brampton Center for Sports and Entertainment, where the Owen Sound Attack have just defeated the Brampton Battalion by a score of 3-1. Currently joined by tonight's third star, Kyle McAllister. And Kyle, definitely, this is a very, very big win for your club.
Yeah, it is big. I mean, we've been, since last year, we've been struggling on the road a bit. And this year, we're not doing too bad lately on the road. But after last night, we were up 5-2 going in the third and we fell apart. And then coming here on the road and stealing a win in their barn is pretty big for us.
Now, definitely you guys off to a little bit of a slow start, but now starting to make your climb up in the standings and now into an eighth place tie with Brampton. How big are these big Midwest Division matchups with clubs like Brampton?
Every team in the Midwest Division is really strong this year, and when you're playing teams in your own conference, or more importantly in your own division, every game is almost like a 4-point game because you're trying to make ground on everybody. So I mean, even a big win tonight on the road, and the points are what we need right now because we're struggling a bit lately.
Now, like you said, a tough game for you guys last night. What can you take from today's win?
We've been playing a lot of good first, second periods, and going into the third, we've been going in with maybe a 2-3 goal lead, and we've been collapsing lately. We got to learn to play in the third, and I think tonight we did a pretty good job. I mean, we laid back a little bit, but I think for the most part we did a pretty good job.
All right, Kyle, thanks a lot. Congratulations on the great game today. Best of luck the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
All right, Kyle McAllister of the Owen Sound Attack, tonight's third star. So a scoreless third period leads the Owen Sound Attack to a 3-1 victory today over the Brampton Battalion. As we look ahead to our next telecast here on OHL Primetime, it will be Sunday, November the 25th, when the Guelph Storm are here in Brampton to take on the Battalion. It will be a 2 o'clock puck drop, and we will be live here from the Brampton Center. The Storm and the Battalion, Sunday, November the 25th. Also, the Ottawa 67s and the Oshawa Generals, that will be coming up tonight here, the OHL Game of the Week at 6:30 here across the Rogers Network. That will about wrap things up for this afternoon. For Doug Anderson and Sam Cosentino, I'm Mike Hancock saying see you next time here on OHL Primetime.